The city of South Bend is ordering the leader of the St. Joseph County Republican Party to demolish a piece of property she and her husband own.
City inspectors say the duplex is a disaster and has to come down. WSBT's Denise Bohn went out to the property today. She's now at the live desk. And Denise, you found out the city's been trying to have them make repairs since 2012.
That's right, Cindy. The property is on the city's list of vacant and abandoned houses. Code enforcement has inspected the property multiple times in the last 2 years and noted little, if any, work has been done. Neighbors say the property has been vacant for at least 7 years, but that just yesterday someone showed up to the house and installed new door locks and boarded up broken windows. But those who live in the neighborhood say those improvements are too little, too late.
It's destroyed.
Robert Voss lives near this dilapidated duplex on South 28th Street, owned by St. Joseph County GOP Chairwoman Deb Fleming and her husband. Plywood covers most of the windows. Doors are falling off hinges, and the backyard fence is gone.
If they had it, why didn't they take care of it? Why, you know, why didn't they move somebody in it?
Records show the property was inspected in October 2012 and cited for 6 violations. 7 months later, a hearing was held and Fleming's husband promised to make repairs. Last month, another inspection discovered no improvement and the couple was ordered to comply. The city now wants the duplex demolished. A hearing is set for this Thursday. These are photos of the inside provided by city code enforcement. Drywall has been ripped down, electrical wiring torn out, along with most of the plumbing.
Court documents show that Fleming and her husband bought the property through an auction back in 2003. How much they paid for it, though, is undisclosed.
Shame on them. Shame, shame. It's a dirty shame.
Tony Ivory has lived next door to the Fleming's duplex for 3 years and in the neighborhood for 7.
It's a crime area, you know, and they use that particular house.
He says no one has lived in the duplex all that time.
This is just a common nuisance. They didn't tear it down.
I made several attempts to reach Fleming and left messages, but didn't hear back from her today. The city says of the 1,100 houses on the vacant and abandoned homes list, 44 have been demolished and another 220 are targeted. If the demolition order is upheld at the hearing later this week, Fleming has 2 years to take down that building. If the city has to do it, then they can go after her for reimbursement. Reporting from the live desk, Denise Bohn, WSBT Channel 22 News.